Dude in the Dark was one thing that I helped found with Dave Shulman. It was pretty successful. It was an energy competition where all the dorms, res halls, fraternities, sororities, Minervas would compete against each other. And the idea was we compared their energy usage in the fall versus winter, and their energy usage of the previous winter with that winter. So we had kind of two baselines to see how much they dropped in energy usage. And I think just about, you know, 3/4 of buildings dropped in energy consumption in a winter that was colder. So that was something that facilities thought was pretty incredible, that it was colder, so you need more natural gas to heat it. But we still managed to drop the electricity and natural gas consumption. In 2007, we helped get wind power back together by having Student Forum put in $10,000. The president matched that. So we had $20,000, and that bought about 15% wind power, which the college is continuing, and we're now part of the American College University President's Climate Commitment. And so President Ainley signed that, and that basically says that we're committed to going carbon neutral at some point, and the Sustainability Committee is gonna help figure out the timeline and how we're gonna, you know, do that. That's kind of a monumental goal.
A few years ago, we had this idea of trying to teach the campus community about eating locally and eating organically and thinking about the food that's going into their systems. And we met with Dining Services and said, can we work this out? Can we do something in the dining halls? And we talked about it for a while. And finally, we came to this idea of, let's make a cafe. Let's do something just once a week, see how popular it is. And so now we have Ozone Cafe every Friday. It's a permanent piece on campus. We're serving upwards of 300 people every week, and we're educating them about the food that's going into their bodies.
Most of the food comes from local farmers, or is organic, and it's mostly vegetarian now too, although I think sometimes they do meat. And they put in a kind of a cool setting, because that's part of Ozone House's mission to be a little more progressive socially. All the students have pink, blue, crazy colored pastel shirts, and they come and serve you this food that Dining Services cooked up, and they kind of tell you a little bit about the food, and that's every Friday. What I think is cool about it is that it's not just students. Faculty will come and sit with you, staff come and sit with you. So you have this good mix of people that are kind of have the same goals, and I think a lot of times there's good discussions that go on there. We don't use dryers for the most part. We kind of hang our clothes up on a line. We have a line inside and outside, so people are actually drying their clothes in the winter, which I think is incredible. We do challenges every once in a while. Like before the end of winter term, we had this challenge where, you know, go a month without drying your laundry, without buying anything, without eating any meat. There are a couple other things that I can't remember, but kind of like these challenges to kind of get us all to be a little bit better in the house.